Hello friends, in this video I am going to give you an introduction about theory of computation subject. So here this computation actually describes about some devices or some mathematical model that do some computation. In the sense like we have calculator, computers and all right, that do some process. And those calculators and computers or the devices, that means that is actually implemented devices, and there are some models that is described, but we haven't formed any devices of it. Okay, so we are going to see about these mathematical model and their theoretical limitations in it. So some computational models along with the theoretical limitation. This theoretical limitation actually describes about the kind of problem that can be solved using these machines or the models. And the computational complexity, like if you can solve a problem using one device, what might be the time and space taken for it. So regarding all those things, we are going to study about it in theory of computation. So here it has three branches. So one is your automata theory. This automata theory actually describes about the computational devices or the mathematical model that do some process. And we have this computability theory. This computability theory actually says like when you can solve a problem using one of the mathematical devices, like we have to check whether the problem can be solvable or not solvable. Like for example, there are some problems which cannot be solved by a computer too. Okay, so this computability theory give a detailed description about this desirable and undesirable problem. And again, if a problem is a solvable one, we have another set called complexity theory that gives a description about the time and space needed for calculating, solving that problem for an algorithm. Okay, so as a whole, this theory of computation deals about some automated theory, some mathematical model and their computable limitations. And if it is computable, what is the complexity of that problem, the solutions? Okay, so that entire study we call it as a theory of computation. And again, in automata theory, like there are major four mathematical model that is always seen. So first, in automata theory, the first one is your finite automata. Like this is a mathematical model that has a very limited memory capability. Like there is no external storage. Whatever a state and the transition that is remembered by a machine, that the process is done. Like one example, that usual example is like an automated door system. So automated door system, we have two states, open and close. And the input to the system is when someone goes and stands in front of it, the door will get open. And if nobody is there, the door will be in a closed state. So actually there are a limited memory capability for it. Like it just remember the input, the current input and the current state, and it makes some transition. So those kind of mathematical model, we call it as a finite automata. There is no external memory unit. And the next one is the push down automata. Like here it uses stack as a memory unit. So some other problems along with this problem solved by this finite automata is solved by your push down automata. And next introduced model is a linear bound automata. A linear bound automata uses a finite tape. The problem with that of a push down automata is like we have stack as a memory unit, right? So when it is a stack, the insertion is done in the topmost element of stack, and when you want to delete an element, again we have to delete the topmost element of the stack, right? So the random access is not possible in case of a push down automata. So they move to a linear bound automata where you have a limited size of tape and a read write head will be there. This read write head can either make a transition to, it can either move to left or right. So based on this tape, we solve some extra problem along with this problem solved by push down automata, and we call that as a linear bound automata. And again, the limitation here is they have taken a finite length of tape as a memory unit. So they again started in doing it, like they another model is developed based on it, and that is called a Turing machine. This Turing machine, like all these things are a model, and this Turing machine is an existing machine. It is implemented and it has an infinite tape as a memory unit. So we have two different infinite tapes where, and a read-write head will be there. It can move in both the direction, left and right. So random access is possible. And again, we have that, unlimited memory is there. So this Turing machine can be compared with that of a computer nowadays. Okay, so when you want like all this study about all this finite automata, Pushdown automata, linear bound automata and Turing machine, we call that as an automata theory. We are going to study about all this model in automata theory. And computability theory describes about the desirable and undesirable language, like when a problem can be solvable or not. And in complexity theory, we are going to study about the time and space complexity of the algorithm that are designed for this any problem. Okay, so as a whole, a study about this mathematical model, their desirability, and then the complexity of the problems, we call that as a theory of computation. Okay, thank you.